You getting audio this time?
I got good audio on you. Tom, we're going to try this thing here. I know you're busy. I've got 2:43 p.m. And maybe we're going to try this thing for just a few minutes. Can you hear me okay, you say?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to try this thing again for just a few minutes today. And it is now, I have been broadcasting for 2305. So this is Tom Britt at Geist over in Geist, Indiana, and he's joined us for a few minutes here today to tell us about his operation and some things he's got coming up. Go ahead, Tom.
How you doing, George? Isn't technology great?
So,
can you hear me okay?
Oh, I can hear you fine, Tom.
Oh, good, good, good. Okay, you want to start over again? Sorry. I'm trying to pull up your site so I can see the feed, so I just want to make sure that I'm centered in the camera.
Okay.
Hang on. Just give me a second here. Let me get it up, okay?
Not a problem. Take your time. But we tried this a few minutes ago, and we ended up with a great video but no audio. And I'm George Price with Pendleton Gazette. Again, we have Tom Britt of At Geist over in Geist, Indiana with us, and he was very generous with his time a few minutes ago and talked to us for quite a while, and then I played the video back and had to apologize to Tom because we had no audio, so we're going to try it again. This is kind of a test he and I are running to see if we can't both have some guests on our shows from time to time that can't, say, come to the studios. So, Tom, back to you. Go ahead.
Back to the studio at Geist, huh?
Yeah.
Well, thanks for having me on, George. As you mentioned, I do the Geist community newsletter. And I'm hearing feedback now. I'm sorry, George. Did you hear that?
Yes. Tom has, again, two websites. He has at geist.com and at carmel.com. He publishes a monthly newsletter to all of his subscribers. As this month's a big newsletter, isn't it, Tom?
Yeah, it's a big one for us a couple different ways. First of all, it's our six-year anniversary, so we're always excited when we have one more year under our belt and we're still in business. That's no small thing. Secondly, it's a big issue page count-wise. It's a 76-page newsletter. We're normally around 32 to 48 pages, so to have something this big is kind of a big deal for us. And thirdly, it's our Geist Half Marathon premier issue. The Geist Half Marathon is a race coming up on May 22nd. It's the race around the reservoir, as we call it. And it's our third year. We've raised over $60,000 for the local schools in the last 2 years. And we're hoping this year we can raise probably $40,000 to $50,000 more, with about 6,500 runners participating.
I tell you, that's a terrific program you got over there. Of course, schools all throughout Indiana, the nation, say, are in trouble money-wise because of the recession, and Indiana, of course, because they changed the tax structure in Indiana. And so a lot of them are trying to figure out how they're going to maintain all their programs they have for the students and keep everything going they had. And it's been quite a ordeal for a lot of schools, but this is a great thing you're doing over there, Tom.
Well, we try, and it's not just me. It's it's a whole organization. We've got a volunteer board of directors who've all come from different walks of life. Most of them are neighbors. A lot of them are from the race professional field, so these are professional race directors and people who own timing companies. And most importantly, we've got about 800 volunteers that come out on packet pickup day, which is the day before, and then race day itself, and they just volunteer their time. So if we had to pay everybody to come out and put this race on, we'd probably go broke. But thanks to the volunteerism we have here in Geist and the greater Geist area, even up in Pendleton, we have people coming down. We're able to generate a lot of revenue that goes right back into schools. And to your point, you're right. It's been the state tax or the property tax system changing, and also the funding formulas for these schools have really put them in dire straits. And it's these public schools are the ones that are really feeling the pinch, because they've been kind of losing kids anyway. over time through, to public or to private schools and charter schools and you name it. And now they're getting squeezed again, and it's just really tough for them.
Okay. Again, when's this race coming up?
It's coming up on May 22nd. It's on a Saturday. And where you'd want to come, if you'd like to sign up and register, the 5K race we have is sold out, but the half marathon is still open. That's 13.1 miles. If you just go to Geist Half, GEISTHALF.com, you can register online, see maps of the course, find out about the timing of everything, and most importantly, where to park. You have to park at HSC High School off of exit 10 on 69, and it gives you some really good instructions on how to get there and where to go so you avoid all the traffic jams.
Okay. And if you, again, if you don't mind, send me an email with the link to the information on your site, and I'll get it in our community calendar and make an announcement. I'll make an announcement tonight because I do a live broadcast at 8 p.m. tonight, get some things together here. And that race is going to start at Hamilton Southeastern. Is that correct, school?
Right. You would park at HSC High School. We'll shuttle you down to the start line. The actual physical start line is about 113th and OEO, about a mile south of the school.
Right.
But we'll give you a free shuttle ride down there. We'll drop you off. You and 6,000 of your best friends will be running around the lake. And then when you're done, we'll give you a free shuttle ride back to your car.
Okay, Tom. Well, we really appreciate it. If you get time today, send me that email. I'll get in the calendar and talk about tonight. And we'll get this broadcast, hopefully, if it worked out okay this time. And I'll get it online so folks that couldn't be with us today can watch it later on.
Well, great. Thanks for your help, George, and good work out there in Pendleton. I know it's a lot of thankless effort, but from one guy to another doing the same thing, I feel your pain, and you're doing good work, so keep it up.
We'll get this thing figured out, Tom, and we'll hope to have you on the show again.
And we'll have you on, too.
All right. Thanks a lot.
All right.
Talk to you later.